This is TWiT.
It's called Full Contact, and it replaces your Apple-provided contact manager. Now, you just better be pretty good if it's going to replace the Apple-provided contact manager, right? It is. And it does a couple of things that everybody wants. First of all, iPad and iPhone, which is great because a contact manager that works on the iPad is really nice. Notice, by the way, I have pictures for almost all of my contacts. In fact, any contact that's not just a company, almost all of them. That's because this merges in contacts from my, unable to sync. Let's try syncing again. It merges in contacts from Facebook, Twitter, my Google contacts, which is where my main contacts are, and my Apple contacts. And it will try to find a picture of somebody, even if it's just their Twitter account or their Facebook account. It has a couple of features that are really great. First of all, it keeps these up to date. So it's noticed that based on maybe LinkedIn, maybe on Facebook, that Bill has updated. So I'm just going to say update that. And now I have his latest information pulled from him. All my contacts are up to date. I can also get rid of duplicates. This is a big issue.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Oops, went to the wrong one.
Google is horrible about that.
Yeah, well, syncing is bad in general because especially if you sync a bunch of different accounts, it's going to err on the side of making an extra one rather than deleting one, right? So it's very handy. Now, I have to say, this duplicate is wrong. It's mixing me up with my dad because we have the same name.
Mm-hmm.
So you will want to look at them before you merge them. See, it's got my picture, my name, but then I see my dad's name. He has a different middle initial. So I see it wants to merge. Basically, this is saying we should really merge your dad's account with yours because I don't put a middle initial on mine. Mm-hmm. I might have to put in a middle initial. I just ignore that when I see that. But there's one more thing that is fantastic. You can add business cards, not by hand, by camera. And I've used these kinds of things before. I'll just use my business cards so we don't give away anybody's personal information. All right, that's it. Now, what happens... I'm going to take the back. A lot of business cards do have something on the back. This mine doesn't. But you can add the back as well. And then what it's going to do, I guess I won't add the back since there's nothing there. What it does is it's hand transcribed by a human.
What?
Yeah. So this is what you're paying for. By a human, which means it's not OCR. So OCR, optical character recognition, can add errors, bad errors. It means you have to check it. But what they've done, I imagine they're using Amazon's Turk or something like that. And so they have a person transcribing the card. And I've put in many cards this way. It's very fast and it's super accurate. And just in case, they keep an image of the card in the contact. Mm. So you still can always say, well, is that right? So I think if you deal with, this is something that happens all the time. By the way, this is a clever technique. A lot of people do this with the Mechanical Turk. They have two people doing it. Mm. And then they match. If they both agree, then they say, yeah, that must be accurate. If they disagree, they get a third party to break the tie. So
they grade the AP exams too.
Yeah.
Marco used to grade them. Mm-hmm.
So this is really fantastic. I am a huge fan of this.
I love it. How much is that going to cost you?
I can't remember. I think it's $15 a year. What does it say on the... on the website there.
$15 a year.
It's not horribly expensive. And I have enough contacts that it really is huge for me. It saves me a lot of time. Oh, there you go. It is not cheap. $99 for this
a year.
It depends on the number of contacts, and nobody's going to ever do the $500 one. What that is there's a team version. And actually, I might do that for all of us. I think it might not be a bad thing for the company to use the Full Contact team solution. So that just as we have, you know, a company LastPass, for instance, and it'd be nice to have a company contact list because we share contacts a lot. You often say, how do I get a hold of this person, vice versa.
Does it have features like CRM features, like customer relations management?
Yeah, well, it's sort of. It's not a full CRM manager, but it will show you all your contacts with that person. It'll
That's what I've looked for.
Let me see if
guests,
I can find
because
somebody.
Because we have so many great guests, and then I have no way to automatically remind me, like, hey, have, you know, this person on again. They were great.
There's contact history. Actually, this may not keep track of your emails and all that other stuff. Mm. I have seen some that have.
Yeah. none are perfect.
Yeah. Maybe not. You know, let me see if I can.
But what you've described is good.
So it will pull up. So I'm looking at Sam's contact. I can then see Sam's social sharing.
Oh.
And then I can see his company info. So there, it's pretty full featured. I think they have a free trial. You should try the free trial and see if it'll do what you want it to do. It is definitely better than Apple's Contact Manager, but you're going to have to decide if it's $99 a year better than Apple's Contact Manager. I think for that you get 40. You get there's a number of scans. You get a number of people. You can store things like that. You pay by the number. I think I spent the $99 for a year.
Well, like all things across Apple and Google, they don't make it easy. When I switched from the iPhone to the Android
phone, this would have solved that, right?
Yeah, it had, like, there were a handful of numbers that I had just added through iCloud that weren't in there.
Yeah. So this full context syncs to iCloud, syncs if you want, syncs to Google if you want. And then if you had done that, you would have then had it, and even Office 365 mm-hmm. and Exchange, you would have then had it in your Google, and you would have had it on your
Android phone. And the faces, never forget a face.
I like the face feature. Mm-hmm. I really do. I like that it finds faces in lots of places. So,
Full contact,
not cheap. It's for some, it's a power tool for people who want to, manage their contacts.